Let me now remind you what we're going to cover next. First, I'll demonstrate that the root mean square displacement of a random walk scales as the square root of time, a central result, a basic central result in the theory of random walks. Next, I'll show that two dimensions is special. In two dimensions and below, a lattice random walk is recurrent, namely, it is sure to return to its starting point. Whereas for dimensions greater than two, the random walk is transient in that its return to the or to its starting point is uncertain. Next, I'll present the probability distribution of the random walk and show how to derive the underlying diffusion equation. Next, I'll discuss this fundamental center limit theorem in which the probability distribution of a random walk is a Gaussian under some very mild restrictions. Finally, I'll present some simple first passage properties of random walks and give some elementary examples. As the first step in understanding the properties of the random walk, let's compute how far a random walk goes as a function of the number of steps in the walk. This is encapsulated by a quantity known as the root mean square displacement. And because root mean square appears so often, we usually label it with the index RMS. So XRMS will be the root mean square displacement of a random walk. So let's, the simplest situation to consider is the Pearson random walk, in which we take steps of fixed length, but random direction. So here each step has length A, and the angle between each step theta is random. So mathematically, we can describe the properties of the Pearson random walk as that the mean value of the single of each single step is equal to A, so fixed step length. Also, there's no bias in the walk, and so the average value of each individual displacement, x sub I, is equal to zero. So here, angle bracket is meant to denote average over all possible realizations of the walk, or all possible realizations of a single step. So this is the statement that there's no bias. And furthermore, because these steps are uncorrelated, that means that the dot product of xi with xj for any I not equal to j is equal to zero. So this is the mathematical statement that there's no correlation between steps, successive steps or steps further down the road. So with these assumptions, let's now calculate the mean displacement of a walk after n steps and the root mean square displacement. So the mean displacement, so I'll denote that by capital X sub n, is just the sum of the individual displacements. So we sum from I equals 1 to n of the x little xi, and we take the average value. But by construction, each xi has an average value 0, so we're summing a whole bunch of values that equal 0, and so we get nothing. Let's now look at the root at the mean squared displacement. So we're going to ask for xn, square it, and then take the average. And so what is this quantity? So again, we have to take the sum of the displacements, xi, I equals 1 to n, square it, and then take the average value. So when we square this sum, this binomial, there are two types of terms. There are so-called diagonal terms where we have xi dotted into xi. And so there'll be terms that look like this, summation I equals 1 to n of xi squared. And then there are all the cross terms where we sum over all possible combinations I not equal to j of xi dot xj, and then we have to take the average value of all of this. So by construction, these cross terms are all zero because there was no correlations between successive steps. So we just forget about this. The diagonal terms, they're all identical. They're the squared length of each individual step. There's n such terms, and so this is nothing more than n a squared. So this quantity, xn squared, is known as the mean square displacement, and the square root of the mean square displacement is precisely the root mean square displacement xrms. So xrms, which is defined to be the square root of the mean square displacement, xn squared average value, This is equal to the square root of nA. So this is our first fundamental result about random walks, which is that the RMS displacement grows not linearly in the number of steps, but only as a square root of the number of steps. So a random walk is actually not very efficient at exploring space. The other point to emphasize here is that there is the factor A, which makes this equation dimensionally correct, because on the left-hand side we have the units of length, and on the right-hand side we have the units of length, and the scaling factor in front is square root of n. This is one of the fundamental results in the theory of random walks.